Hi, this is Greta Brokaw from Heart Medicine Devotions, and this is a little different format today. I've never done the live podcast before, but the Lord's just put some things on my heart that I wanted to share with you. So if you've tuned in, we're going to be talking about bushels of blessings. We're going to talk about God's goodness to us and how He is just so kind and so gracious with us. And if you'd like to find more heart medicine resources, whether you want to read our devotions, whether you want to get books, or if you want to listen to other podcast episodes, whatever we can do to help you, just go to myheartmedicine.com. Go to myheartmedicine.com. You'll find lots of resources there. And you can also contact me through the website if you ever need a singer, a speaker for an event, for your ladies at your church, or if I can help you in any way, if you want prayer. Just contact me through the website. I would love to hear from you. I always love hearing from all the people who support and pray for heart medicine. So let's get into our little devotional for today. I'm going to start reading in Psalm 103, and I'm going to read verses 1 to 5. It says, "Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless His holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all His benefits, who forgiveth all thine iniquities, who healeth all thy diseases, who redeemeth thy life from destruction, who crowneth thee with loving kindness and tender mercies, who satisfieth thy mouth with good things, so that thy youth is renewed like the eagles." And you know, when I saw that verse, "satisfieth thy mouth with good things, so that thy youth is renewed like the eagles," I shared a story with a couple friends last night about how I just saw a pattern of God's blessing in my life. Simple things, but I just want to share it with you because maybe it'll encourage you. Maybe it will help you to find your own pattern of blessings from God in your life. And it has to do with tomatoes. You know, if tomatoes could talk, they would tell you that God loves me, that God cares about my simple desires, my simple wants, and He is my good Father who honestly looks for opportunities to surprise me with His blessings. And I praise Him and thank Him for it. And I saw that recently with tomatoes. I have always loved tomatoes all my life. And I married Paul. Paul hates tomatoes. He thinks they're absolutely disgusting. He has no use for them. And therefore, both of our sons, Justin and Joey, have grown up learning to hate tomatoes. So that leaves me as the odd man out. And so honestly, for the first few years that Paul and I were married, I never even bothered to buy tomatoes, even though I loved them. And I can remember eating different things and thinking, oh, this would be so nice with tomatoes on it or with a slice of tomato. But I never bothered buying those things just because, you know, why am I going to spend that money just for me if nobody else in the house is interested in it? And so I just went without for a few years. And that changed, you know, as the years went by. I would get tomatoes here and there or that for myself at the house. But last year we were on a camping trip. And we were trying to get to the campground. We passed a farmer's stand that had tomatoes on it, and I wanted to stop and get some tomatoes. But I knew that we were trying to keep a schedule, and so I didn't bother my husband. I didn't want to, you know, slow us down. So I just looked longingly at the tomatoes as we drove by them. And then when we got to the campground and we're setting everything up and that, I said, you know, Lord, I know it sounds crazy. I know it sounds foolish, but I would just really love some tomatoes. If you could give me some tomatoes somehow. You know, we're on our summer camping trip, so it's the perfect time to be eating stuff like that. And then we went on our trip, you know, we went on about our business and we were having a great time and everything. 2 days later, I believe it was, my husband went to pick up some firewood. He said, I saw a place they had campfire wood up the road. So I'm just going to go and get a bundle for the fire tonight. And I was like, okay. So he heads out to get that. He comes back with his firewood and with a big paper bowl, you know, one of those paper salad bowls of tomatoes. And he says to me, yeah, I went and I bought the camp wood. And after I went up to the house and paid for it, he said, the woman came running out after me and she said, could you use some tomatoes? And he said, he told her, well, I don't like them, but my wife loves them. My wife would love them. And so sure enough, she told him how she just had an excess of tomatoes from her garden and she was trying to get rid of them. And please, please take these to your wife. So he came back with a bowl of tomatoes for me and I ate them all. And then the next time that he went back to get more camp wood at the same spot, she gave him another bowl of tomatoes to bring back to me. And it was just a sweet little blessing. It sounds trivial. It sounds foolish. But that is how our God is with us. He knows us intimately. If you know him as your Savior, he delights to do good things for you. And he even sends his rain on the just and the unjust. So even if you don't know Jesus as your Savior, God is still good to you. You need the greatest blessing of all, which is salvation and forgiveness and eternal life through the blood of Jesus Christ. But God is a gracious, gracious God. And you know, I got another reminder, the story's not over, because this summer, I have several friends who have planted gardens, some of them really big gardens. And so I have been showered with tomatoes. I kid you not. My one friend who comes to Bible study at my house, she literally gave me more than a bushel of cherry tomatoes. And I was able to make some things with them. I was able to just eat them as they are. But I mean, it reminded me again, it took me back to that story from last year on the camping trip. And it just reminded me, I was having a little praise service in my kitchen yesterday thinking, God, you are so good to me. All the years that I did, that I deprived myself of tomatoes. And then last year you gave me a couple bowls of them. And this year you're literally giving me bushels of them. And you know, like I said, it can sound silly, but those are the things that we need to hang on to and that we need to remember when we are struggling in other areas of our lives. When we are in a valley over something else, be it a relationship, a situation, maybe a financial need, a health need, you need those little stories of God's goodness to you to recall to mind. You know, the Bible says, this I recall to mind, therefore I have hope. That's what Jeremiah wrote in the book of Lamentations. And then he said, it is because of the Lord's mercies that we are not consumed. He said that his mercies are new every day and great is his faithfulness. And we need to be able to remind ourselves to that. We need to be able to recall even silly, small things to mind where the Lord has surprised us, where the Lord has made us smile, where the Lord has met needs in creative, amazing ways, where the Lord has given us abundance, because he gives us abundance all the time. Psalm 13:8 says, I will sing to the Lord because he hath dealt bountifully with me. And I'm telling you, we live in a culture today, we live in a world today where we are constantly being upset and angered and whipped into a frenzy over what we don't have. And we need to circle back to remembering what we do have in Christ, you know, because, and I'm not saying that needs aren't legitimate. I'm not saying that we don't need help from the Lord. I'm not saying that, and if you are in a hard place today, my heart goes out to you, but we just need to stake our day on the fact that God has been good to us, because it will change our outlook. It will change our attitude. It will help us to be coming from a place of grace when we deal with the hardships of life, rather than coming from a place of discouragement and discontent and anger and stress. So I just wanted to share that with you today. And really, I want to pray with you right now, because I want you to find your own bushels of blessing in your life. And I want you to recall them to mind so that you have the hope that you need to get through today and to get through this week. So let's just go to God in prayer right now. Father God, I thank you for this day. I thank you, thank you, thank you for tomatoes. I thank you for bushels of blessings. I thank you for years and years worth of blessings in every area of my life. Even at times when I was far away from you, God, and even at times when I had no hope and I was discouraged, Father God, I thank you that you are that God who pours out your rain on the just and the unjust. And I thank you, Father God, that for those who know you, the blessings are even more abundant, because Jesus came that we might have life and that we might have it more abundantly. I pray if there's anyone under the sound of my voice who does not know Jesus as their Savior, Father God, that they would come to you, that they would realize that although you are a holy God, you are a loving God, and you made a way through Jesus Christ for them to find you. And I pray, Father God, that you would help those who are discouraged and who are down today, that you would help them to find the crazy little patterns of your goodness and your blessing in your life, so that they can recall those things to mind and have hope. Thank you that you are who you say you are. You do what you promise to do. Father God, help us today. We praise you and we thank you, because we know that our lives overflow with your goodness. In Jesus' name, amen. So I hope that was a blessing to you, and I hope that you can find the blessings of God in your life and hang on to them to get through everything else. And I hope you'll go to myheartmedicine.com, get in touch with me, get some resources, read some devotionals, do whatever you can to keep your heart right with God and to see the best in life, so that God can use you, so that God can use you for His glory and for His purposes and for His work. Until next time, God bless you.